an extraordinary night.
Big Smash!
It's cool. And here comes the new World Wrestling Federation champion, a man who is scheduled to go to WrestleMania on April the 1st and defend the WWE title against Stone Cold Steve Austin. What a war that The Rock and Kurt Angle wage have no way out. It was a match that literally could have gone either way on several occasions.
I was beginning, JR, to wonder if we would ever see this sight again. The Rock proudly standing upon that turnbuckle and holding the WWF title over his head.
Ladies and gentlemen,
there it is.
But once again, the WWE champion. And we'll see championships decided here tonight. The Intercontinental Champion, the tag team titles on the line tonight. But The Rock has taken center stage, and rightfully so. And the Rocky chant here in Phoenix begins. The new champion can smell what these fans are cooking here in Phoenix.
Now he's on the right to revel in this.
Finally, The Rock has come back to Phoenix.
And he's come back as the WWF champ.
And finally, one day after No Way Out, the time has come that The Rock stands right in the middle of the people's ring. Exactly the way he said he would, WWF champion.
That's exactly right. The Rock said he was gonna come back with a title, and he's done it.
It's true, it's true. This place is electric tonight, they are.
What a great atmosphere.
Wow,
what a great night for our fans to be with us.
Kurt Angle. Last night at No Way Out, you showed The Rock two sides of your personality. During the match, you showed The Rock a vicious side, an unrelenting side. The Rock saw a man who kicked out of the people's elbow. The Rock saw a man who had no problem in almost snapping The Rock's ankle in two. Kurt Angle, last night at No Way Out, you bought it to The Rock. And The Rock respects that.
Wow. Respects Kurt Angle.
He should.
But then Kurt Angle, after the match, we saw the other side.
Oh, now wait a minute.
What side would that
be? There was a lot of emotion, JR.
The other side of the match, the other side of your personality after the match, walking up the ramp saying this, crying, moaning, bitching, and complaining.
Again?
Yes. Actually running your mouth. Well, it's okay. I still have my three eyes. I still have my milk.
Man.
I still have my milk, but oh, it's not fair. The Rock never beat me. I won the match. It's my title. I've never had sex with a woman before.
Wait a minute.
Just not fair.
Kurt didn't say that, did he? How did The Rock know that?
I didn't hear that, but... This crowd jacked up for The Rock, the new WWF champion.
Kurt Angle, last night at No Way Out, The Rock beat you for the WWF title. The Rock is going on to WrestleMania. So Kurt Angle, you want to bitch and moan? You want to complain to everybody in the back? Kurt Angle, you want to bitch?
Oh.
Well, The Rock says, why don't you come out and bitch at The Rock?
Wait, he's not calling out Kurt Angle, is he?
Well, it sure sounds that way.
is here.
Now, Rock, you don't want any more Kurt Angle.
All right. This is not Kurt Angle. This is Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Oh, my God.
The man that's going to fall against the WWE champion, The Rock, at WrestleMania on April the 1st. This is not Kurt Angle.
What a war Steve Austin was in last night in No Way Out.
And Austin's got the scars to prove it. What a hellacious match! As good as I've ever seen! Stone Cold and The Rock got it on in three bloody falls! With Triple H coming out on top! Austin is quite frankly, he's stealing The Rock's spotlight here!
He's stealing all the thunder from the new WWE champ! I guarantee you, Rock don't appreciate this one bit. Look at this look. Oh, boy. Thinking in his mind, he'd like to lay a smackdown right now.
You feel the electricity here, I can tell you. And look at The Rock. Obviously not pleased.
The reason I'm out here is I got a couple of things to get off my chest.
Uh-oh.
First of all, Rock, congratulations on winning the WWF title last night.
Wow. What?
Kurt Angle can cry all he wants, but the fact is the better man won, so more power to you.
Boy, a lot of props being dealt out tonight.
But I got some advice for you. As long as you're the WWF champion, as long as you're going to WrestleMania as the WWF champion, Stone Cold Steve Austin, advice to you is just to stay healthy.
Uh-oh, stay healthy.
All you got to do is stay healthy.
What's he mean by that? He gives as good as my...
Don't leave.
Uh-oh. Maybe you should let him leave, Rock.
It might be the better way. This could explode right in our faces here tonight.
He ain't leaving.
There they are, The Rock, the WWE champion, the man The Rock will meet, Stone Cold Steve Austin at WrestleMania.
The Rock appreciates your advice. But Stone Cold, The Rock has some advice of his own.
Oh boy.
The Rock has two words of advice for you. Simply put, get ready.
Oh, my. I don't think Austin has to be encouraged to get ready. What a WrestleMania main event this is going to be, and you're looking right at it. Look at the eyes of those two tremendous competitors, King.
Uh-oh.
And now the trash talking begins.
Yeah. Get that microphone up there. I want to hear it.
If you smell. What The Rock.
Oh, my gosh.
It's cooking.
Rock, I don't know if you heard or not, but I assume in the interest of fairness, Mr. McMahon has put you into a triple threat match for the hardcore title, and your opponents, Kurt Angle and The Big Show.
Michael Cole, The Rock knows that you obviously know how to dress like a 14-year-old little girl.
Ah!
Let The Rock ask you this. Can you read?
Of course.
Well, what does The Rock's shirt say?
It doesn't matter.
Well, considering how The Rock feels about The Big Show and Kurt Angle, you bet your ass it doesn't matter.
Kids, hey, Angle's over here choking The Rock. Man, I got him covered. What the hell's going on here?
Remember the show's title, the hardcore title at stake here.
Hey.
This looks like World War
so.
It's Papa Holly.
Oof. On the big. Falls down anywhere.
Well, Big Show's a mock man, JR.
Hardcore Holly being manhandled for the 500 pounder. And now Steve Blackman thrown into the railing.
That was the one, right? The one just got a boot by Show. Show's got a big bullseye on his head.
That big son of a gun is still standing.
But The Rock is getting whooped right now. That angle has been centered.
This son of a gun's out of control. The center. Over. And Kurt Angle working on The Rock.
They're targeting his ankle. Looks like they're targeting his leg or his ankle.
Center took it at The Rock. Angle has orchestrated this whole thing. Kurt Angle directing the crier here. A cruel crier trying to cripple The Rock. And The Rock trying to fight back. And he is with everything he's got left. But down goes the WWE champion. The odds are too great. And now look, there's Kurt Angle.
It's filmed into the back.
This is the damnedest thing I've ever seen.
Hardcore rules. You gotta love it. Oof.
Oh, what a shot to the spine of Blackman. And Billy, the one Billy Gunn, he's a 6'5", looks like a baby compared to the Big Show.
Well, live, Billy Gunn's a stud, and he does look like a... Oh, I didn't see that.
And the Big Show still not off his feet.
What does it take to put this man down?
My God, the heart... There's S.A. Reels is back in the fray. But not for long.
There's still triple teaming The Rock in the ring, Albert, Saturn. And look at Angle, he's definitely orchestrating this, JR.
Angle directly trapping the ring on the Big Show.
Look at this. He's like, two, Mexican on.
That's amazing. That is amazing. The Big Show with a horizontal pin.
The world wrestling.
Still retains his hardcore title, but the story back to the ring is that The Rock is being destroyed. The Rock is being decimated here. Saturn, Albert, and Kurt Angle beating the living hell out of The Rock, who's trying to fight back here.
He's fighting back. Here he comes, JR. Here comes the Brahma Bull. Boom!
The Rock will never die, but he's almost beheaded by Saturn. And look at this, Albert, 6'8", 350.
Being triple team. I mean, you know, he is The Rock, but that's two big balls in there on him. Boom! Oh, wow, what a shot by Albert.
Unbelievable contact. What impact that move on. But The Rock retaliates. The Rock fighting for his life here. Spinebuster.
Man, The Rock just shifted it in another gear. Boom! Spit, baby!
Great turn to the SmackDown. Oh, wait a minute.
Just turn the angle up. There it is.
What a chaotic scene here tonight!
Look at the look in both these guys' eyes!
No doubt The Rock is a marked man! Will The Rock be able to stay healthy? And is there a damn thing that Stone Cold can do about it? Here they come! Here they come!
You know, Kurt, I'm in the back icing down a cooler of beers. And I hear you out here flapping your gums about how many titles you won, how many awards you won, and it don't impress me one single bit. Then you go out there and you keep on to say how angry you are. I don't give a damn how mad you are, Kurt. Then you go on to mention two names. You mentioned Stone Cold Steve Austin, and you mentioned The Rock. So I figure, hey, Kurt Angle's got something important to say finally. I was wrong. What you went on to say, and I'll paraphrase it, was you said, you're either gonna whip my ass, or you're gonna whip The Rock's ass. And then whoever's you whip, they're gonna get carried out by a stretcher. That's what you said.
Well, that is what he said. Pretty much it.
As far as The Rock goes, Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock ain't pals. We ain't drinking buddies. It ain't nothing like that. What The Rock is the World Wrestling Federation champion. So I said I got a vested interest in his health. But you know what? Since you ain't the WWF champion, I could give a rat's ass about your health.
Uh-oh. Thank you,
so if you want me to whip this city slicker's ass, give me a hell yeah. Kurt Angle. You actually have the nerve, the audacity to come out here running your mouth and try and stir things up between The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin. You see, The Rock says that's fine because The Rock and Stone Cold have something you don't have, something you couldn't possibly fathom. The Rock and Stone Cold, WWF title match at WrestleMania. And quite frankly put, The Rock and Stone Cold have a date with destiny.
That they do, April 1st, man, at the Astrodome in Houston, 65,000 strong to see those two men go at it.
Could happen right here.
Well, you can feel the tension building, JR, as these two competitors stare holes in one another.
Stone Cold, with all due respect, you may have a vested interest in the WWF Championship, but let The Rock make one point perfectly clear, crystal clear. The Rock doesn't want your help, and The Rock doesn't need your help.
That was pretty clear to me.
Well, wait a minute, apparently I see it differently. I see it that
it doesn't matter how you see it. Because the fact of the matter is this, is The Rock came out here for one reason and one reason only. And if there's gonna be anybody whooping your candy, it's gonna be The Rock.
Yeah, there's two men that wanna kick Angle's rear end.
Angle with the challenge, either or, The Rock or Stone Cold. Look at Austin, look at, and The Rock staring at each other. I certainly hope everyone appreciates the gravity of this situation. Quite frankly, I'm impressed. I'm impressed. I'm certainly not impressed with these crude individuals here in Arizona.
Rather unsavory chant directed toward Mr. McMahon.
But I am impressed with Kurt Angle.
Why?
When you consider the size of the grapefruits that it takes to come out here and challenge in one night either Stone Cold or The Rock, that's impressive.
Well, that's a good point.
And of course, we do have a problem that you've created, Kurt. Which one of these two individuals will face you here tonight? Well, being the problem solver in life that I am, I think I can handle this one. You see, Rock, before I knew Kurt Angle was coming out here, before I knew you were coming out here, despite the fact that you competed at No Way Out, despite the fact you almost had your ankle broken last Monday night, here in this very ring tonight.
Oh, no.
You will be defending the World Wrestling Federation Championship.
Here tonight? Against?
And you will be defending that title against a most deserving individual. William Regal.
William Regal in The Rock tonight with the title.
Which of course means Stone Cold. As far as you're concerned, you versus Kurt Angle.
Austin and Angle, Rock and Regal here tonight.
Austin likes it. Angle got his wish. Regal gets a title shot at The Rock.
What if it's gonna be me and Kurt Angle? It ain't no use to wait until late.
Austin wasting little time. William Regal going at it. Oh, hell is broken loose. Oh, right out in front of us. The Rock is sending a message.
Austin assaulting Kurt Angle. They're getting on officially tonight. William Regal is taking the high ground. Mr. McMahon then stops the bullet. But the WWE title on the line tonight.
The Rock defends against William Regal. The title on the line. Stone Cold Steve Austin goes one-on-one with Kurt Angle.
And how can Mr. McMahon say William Regal is a deserving competitor?
That guy is going to be an out-of-control ride.
Angle challenging The Rock and Austin earlier tonight.
How Mr. McMahon set this matchup, Austin versus Kurt Angle.
Austin on Sunday night at No Way Out had the living hell beat out of him, as did Triple H. Austin in a losing effort. You gotta wonder how much gas is in the tank of the Rattlesnake here tonight.
You making excuses for the Rattlesnake?
Of course I'm not. I was there, I come into the match, it's only a fact.
Well, The Rock was there too, and he went 30 minutes with Kurt Angle, walked out WWF champion.
And this crowd comes to its feet, chanting for the Rattlesnake. Stone Cold slowly makes it to his feet, and here comes Stone Cold.
Austin fighting back with whatever he's got left, and now Austin counters with a suplex of his own.
Both Austin Angle down, center of the ring. Stone Cold back to his feet.
Ooh.
And Angle counters.
Angle front face locking, Austin right back down on the canvas. That's smart wrestling by Angle, like him or not.
Angle, the former WWF champion, in control of the Stone Cold Steve Austin.
The front face lock is right into a choke lock. You know that as well as I do. And certainly Angle is not above cheating to gain the advantage.
Well, it's on another 3 inches. It probably is. As a matter of fact, it's probably a choke right now. But knowing Stone Cold, and speaking of cheating, look at him.
Angle using the ropes as Austin tries to make it to the ropes.
And as we know, Stone Cold, there's a fire inside of Stone Cold, a desire, a burning desire, and he should come out of this. The Rock knows all about that, because The Rock has just that much more.
Well, Rock, what are we going to see at WrestleMania? Is it going to be scientific, Texas Cat Can, or is it going to be in your face, smash mouth?
The Rock's not going to tell you that, but the one thing The Rock can tell you is Stone Cold Steve Austin's motto, don't trust anybody. And The Rock's motto, just bring it.
I've seen a lot of WrestleMania since I've been here, and I can honestly tell everybody I have never looked forward to a WrestleMania as much as the one coming up on April 1st as Austin gets right back into this thing.
Stone Cold with the right hand, battling back against Angle, and here comes the Rattlesnake.
There's the desire, there's the fire.
Oh, look at this. Suplex by Austin. Suplex by Austin.
Austin's intensity, Rock, much like yours, it's a never say die. Neither one of you will ever quit.
You'll never ever see quitting The Rock just like Stone Cold Steve Austin. You can count on when The Rock looks you dead in the eye. He means everything he says, and he'll do whatever he says he's gonna do.
The Rock, let's face it, at WrestleMania, somebody may have to say, that's enough, I can't go anymore.
Well, it damn sure won't be The Rock.
And Stone Cold with the right hand to Kurt Angle. Austin is starting to build momentum. Reversal up off the ropes. Here comes Stone Cold. Ducks underneath the right hand. Muthas press to Angle. And there are the right hands by Austin.
Austin dancing with Brody. And that's those right hands.
And Austin right across the throat of Kurt Angle. Angle's in trouble. Stone Cold.
That's got to take it out of his game. Austin, that brawling style.
Austin with the shots to the gut of Kurt Angle. The rattlesnake. The former champion off the ropes. Look at this. Kurt Angle. Oh, look at this. The belly to belly. Tremendous counter by Kurt Angle.
A great counter by Angle as Austin was looking for the stunner. Countering into the suplex. Wait a minute. Challenge the Rock.
Challenge the Rock. Here's a man that the Rock whipped his candy ass. How many times the Rock have to whip his European candy ass?
Oh, Regal. Rock and Regal. Exchanging blows outside the ring.
The Rock hammering Regal down. The Rock. Wait a minute. The Rock throwing Regal in the ring.
William Regal tossed into the ring by the Rock. And now Austin passed away on William Regal.
Rock is tired of whipping his candy jabroni ass.
The Rock, what have you done?
Someone out to this ring, and I'm gonna take them out of that match. So, if you can stand the humiliation of doing it one more time, if you can stand to get your ass kicked in front of the world one more time by the better man, then Austin, bring your ass to this ring, and let's finish the game.
Oh, yeah. Austin. Triple H is calling out the rattlesnake. What the hell is...
He's not just calling him out, he's calling his bluff. If Austin has the guts, he has to fight the man that beat him two straight falls.
Oh, here comes the Texas Rattlesnake.
Stone Cold Steve Austin and You see, Deborah, that changes things. So I would have to have you go talk to Steve and make sure everything's cool with him.
You getting ready for your match?
I'm trying to.
Thought you might need to know this, that I just talked to Mr. McMahon.
You talked to who? What are you talking to Mr. McMahon about? You can't trust him.
In the interest of fairness, officially, as of now, you are managing The Rock.
Austin's last manager, The Rock, and by God, what does this mean at WrestleMania in the Reliant Astrodome? Oh, my God! And here comes Triple H from behind. Austin was right in Mr. McMahon's face. It's The Rock and Austin against Triple H and Kurt Angle. I cannot believe what Mr. McMahon has done here.
This is what you call a mind game.
The Rock toys. He's set. He's cocked. He's ready. Rock bottom. This mess continues.
And he's going for it. He's going for it.
Angle going for the ankle lock. He'll break the Rock's ankle. And Austin just saved the Rock from getting his ankle broken. The referee just grabbed him. There's a Stone Cold Stunner. Austin going for the cover.
But his wife is distracting the referee.
The Rock now going for the cover.
Oh, listen to me. I know. It was great Monday night. Listen, Trish was humiliated beyond belief. It was one of the proud... Listen, tonight you're not going to believe the surprise I have for you. No, this is a really, really good surprise. Because it's better than Monday night. This is going to be humiliation like you wouldn't believe. All right, come in. Because this humiliation is more personal even than Trish, isn't it? Let me call you back.
You got just a minute?
Yeah, you seem upset.
Yeah, I'm a little upset right now. Can I talk to you about a couple
Absolutely.
Of things?
Absolutely, please sit down.
Well, Mr. McMahon, first of all, it's really, I am so shocked about this. It's number one, how you treated Trish Stratus. I cannot, you totally degraded her. You insulted her in front of all those people. And I don't believe that's how you treat a woman. I don't agree with that.
Well, let me just say this. I know you're upset.
Yeah.
And a lot of other women are upset, and I understand that, because that's no way to treat a lady. I agree with you. I want you to understand that I have the utmost respect for women. Respect. But I've got... Let me just say this, too, about Trish. Trish, Deborah, Trish is trash. All right, I mean, she's not like you, all right? She's not like any other woman that's here. She's trash. And I admit I went too far. I did. I got carried away. And she could have said no at any time, all right? But I got carried away, and I apologize, and you'll never see anything like that again. I humbly apologize. And
okay.
We're okay then, well, you and me? And
yeah,
is that why you wanted to see me?
Well, no. The second thing that's really upsetting me, too, is I cannot believe that you tricked me into managing The Rock. And you know good and well he's going against my husband, Stone Cold Steve Austin, at WrestleMania.
Listen, you know, I'm accused so many times of like, being this Machiavellian character that, you know, that thinks that in a devious way. And look, I want to let you understand that, you know, as much as my reputation is that way, from a realistic standpoint, I'm not that kind of man. Let me just say... what happened, all right? And hopefully you believe me. If you don't, I understand, and we can talk about that too. But from my standpoint, you came to me, and Deborah, you shocked me Monday night. You resigned. You walked out on me. You resigned as Lieutenant Commissioner. Well, you know, how did I feel about that? You know, and then you say, well, you want to go back to managing, and I'm saying, well, you know, here's a lady who's given everything to the WWF. Here's a lady who's been loyal, a lady who's been a consummate professional, and a lady that I want to reward. So how can I best reward Deborah? Because she deserves it. And the only thing that popped in my mind was you managing the WWF champion. I said to myself, that's going to be fantastic. And granted, you know, as I even said the words and I thought I was rewarding you, it's like, I could understand now the conflicts of Stone Cold and The Rock and where that puts you. And I see that too, but... And if this is that much of a conflict for you, then then let me just say that, Deborah, I've always thought of you as a career woman. I've always thought of you as someone who's goal-oriented. But if you want to go back to Texas and be a housewife, I can understand your point of view, but it would be awfully disappointing, because if there's one thing that I think I know about you, is you don't turn your back on a challenge. And this, Deborah, unquestionably, I see it now clearly.
No, I'm willing to do this, most definitely. But I just didn't agree with the way you went about it.
Well, again, I didn't see it for what it was. I thought I was rewarding you. You deserved to be...
It just made me feel very uncomfortable.
I get it. So you're still in and you still want to accept
this
challenge?
Oh, yeah, absolutely.
All right, then. A deal is a deal.
Yeah.
And just one other thing?
Because it's my job, right?
And you're a professional.
That's correct.
And just one other thing before you go, I can't help but admire it. That's a very beautiful necklace you're wearing.
Just kind of a habit, I guess. It's like on the limb doesn't know how to do it. So you had the conversation, right?
Yeah. Well, I went and talked to Mr. McMahon, and I told him, yes, I want my career back, my job. And then I also told him that I didn't agree with who's got me managing. You know that.
Yeah, well, first of all, I'm for your career 100%. I think you're a great manager, and I want you to be as happy as you can be. But Vince McMahon tricked you. That's the bottom line. Nobody knows that man like Stone Cold Steve Austin, because I've been through it all with him. And you got to appreciate the situation you put me in, Deborah. I mean, here it is. You're managing The Rock, the same man that I'm going to WrestleMania with for the WWF title, and you're going to manage him. You understand the kind of position this puts me in?
I know.
Well, I just hope it all works out for the best.
Rock, an unexpected turn on the road to WrestleMania. Last Monday night on Raw, Mr. McMahon shocked us all when he informed you that your new manager is going to be Stone Cold Steve Austin's wife, Deborah.
You know, Kevin Kelly, you asked The Rock about the road to WrestleMania. Well, ever since No Way Out, the road to WrestleMania was a very clear road. It was The Rock and Stone Cold Steve Austin on a collision course to a date with destiny. But now, however, the road to WrestleMania is a very unclear road, a foggy road, a bumpy road, and there's a roadblock in that road, and her name is Deborah. You see, Deborah, let The Rock make one thing perfectly clear. Is personally, The Rock has no problem with you. The Rock respects you. But the only problem is this, is that The Rock doesn't need you. You see, Deborah, The Rock's entire career, he's never had a manager, never needed a manager. But now, just weeks away from the biggest match in the history of The Rock's career, weeks away from the biggest match in the history of this entire industry, Stone Cold Steve Austin, his wife is now The Rock's manager. And Deborah, The Rock realizes, now that Vince McMahon has appointed you the manager to The Rock has no choice but to accept it. But Deborah, let The Rock ask you one question, just one question. And that question is this, is can you accept the fact that in weeks from now, April 1st, WrestleMania 17, the biggest of all time, The Rock and Stone Cold, the biggest of all time. Deborah, can you accept the fact that you can't stop The Rock from whipping your husband's candy ass?
Rikishi and Akutu, and look at The Rock battling back. The Brahma Bull taking a boot to the face.
face, and every time, Taz, The Rock tries to build some momentum, Rikishi and Haku stop him in his tracks.
Damn right they're stopping his tracks, but you gotta give him The Rock. Okay. He's all hot, he won't quit, he'll keep fighting back.
I don't know how much The Rock has left, trying to struggle to his feet as he grabs the second rope, and look at Rikishi just stalking The Rock. That sick, sinister smile on this evil man, Rikishi. The same man who drove a car to run over Stone Cold Steve Austin. The same man who says he's gonna deliver a stink face to Deborah here tonight.
No, and when Rikishi says it, I don't think it's a threat. This is something that these guys were told, I guess, a promise he's gonna come through with. He gives that stink face to Deborah. I mean, what's that gonna mean? What's that gonna mean for Rock? What's that gonna mean for Deborah's face?
The Rock into the corner. Rikishi about to back it on up. Here comes 400 pounds. Exploding out of the corner with a clothesline. Desperation by the Brahma Bull.
The Brahma Bull came out of that corner like a bullet. Oh, man, what a shot.
Rock has no one to tag. Rikishi can tag Haku. Rikishi's struggling. He needs to make it to his corner and look at the concern on the face of The Rock's manager, Deborah.
She should be concerned. The people should be concerned. The Rock should be concerned. He's in a lot of trouble, Cole. A lot of trouble.
Are the people behind The Rock? Here comes Haku in off the tag. The Rock slowly to his feet. And Haku, look at The Rock, sucking the right hand. The Brahma Bull, that innate athletic ability, starting to bring The Rock back. The Rock's athletic ability off the cage as he battles back against Rikishi.
He don't quit, Cole. He's a warrior.
DDT.
Just like you said, can't stop The Rock.
The Brahma Bull with the right hand to Haku. Oh, look at this. The double team just too much as Rikishi knocks The Rock down.
I mean, he's just, you know, he's trying. He's busting his ass out there. But there's not much he can do against these two monsters.
I mean, it's bad enough going in the ring against Haku or Rikishi. But when you have to face both of these men, the task is daunting.
And his legs are like spaghetti. He can't hold himself up. I mean, he's...
Oh, look at ducked underneath Rikishi. Spinebuster.
Ready for the power to do that. Oh,
the guts, the adrenaline of The Rock. He's creating an opportunity. Can he capitalize? Stalking Rikishi. And look at Haku. Look at this.
Rock bottom.
WWF champion has done it. There's not much left of The Rock, but The Rock somehow came through.
The Rock.
He survived, Cole, and he still got the WWF championship.
The Rock will face Stone Cold with the title on the line at WrestleMania. And Rikishi with a shot on the mud kick to the face of The Rock.
Right on the jaw, Cole. Bam! Right
this match is over.
Uh-oh.
Oh, no. 425-pound bonsai drop into the ribs of The Rock. He may have cracked some ribs.
The people's heart just squashed.
Rikishi staring at Deborah. He wouldn't do it.
No, Rikishi, don't do this. This is someone's wife.
Deborah is scared to death. It's Austin's wife. The Rattlesnake's wife is scared to death. Rikishi had his marching orders. No, not the stink face.
This ain't right, Cole. This ain't right, man. Someone's got to stop. This ain't right.
And Haku's holding Deborah. Haku is holding Deborah. Somebody stop them.
Like they need to hold her, please.
Rikishi, Haku have got their orders. Stink face to Deborah. And Deborah, look at her.
Oh, man.
Oh, no. Rikishi about to back it up. Rikishi, imagine the stench.
He's taking
the smell.
He's taking his time.
Wait a minute. The Rattlesnake,
bam,
coming to the end of his wife, saving Deborah from the steel
stunner.
Stunner to Rikishi.
And that's his wife, man. You can't blame Austin.
Stone Cold is out of control. Austin has lost
are managing The Rock.
Austin's wife's managing The Rock? What the hell is that?
You got to appreciate the situation you put me in, Deborah. I mean, here it is. You're managing The Rock, the same man that I'm going to WrestleMania with for the WWF title, and you're going to manage him. Do you understand the kind of position this puts me in?
Well, Rikishi and Haku set for a handicap match against The Rock. And
we're going to take The Rock out. And you know, I ran down Stone Cold Steve Austin with a car. But tonight, I'm going to run my ass right into his wife's face.
The guts, the adrenaline of The Rock. He's created an opportunity. Look at this. Staring at Deborah, the Rattlesnake's wife is scared to death. Rikishi had his marching orders. No, not the stink face. Wait a minute, Stone Cold coming to a twice aid.
Oh my God,
Austin has lost it. Austin is livid. The Rattlesnake is off the charts.
Austin making, wait a minute. Stone Cold for the first time realizing his wife has stayed with The Rock. Stone Cold Steve Austin looking back. He can't be pleased. What thoughts are going through the mind of the Rattlesnake?
Can't be four.
Hey, do you have a problem with my wife?
Hey, I was just saying.
Hey, shut up. And make it real simple, Kurt. I am the last son of a bitch that you want to piss off. Do you understand me?
I don't have a problem with that. I don't have a problem with you either, Steve. Yet. But after I win the title tonight, I will see you at WrestleMania, the WWF champion. How do you like that?
Hey, Rock. Hey, just so we understand each other, I just had a little talk with Kurt. And if something happens to Deborah, I'm gonna whip his ass. And just so you know, I'll whip your ass too.
Now, The Rock understands your concern. And you should be concerned because it's your wife. But don't you ever come into The Rock's locker room again and tell The Rock of his responsibilities. The Rock has one concern tonight, and that's taking care of Kurt Angle. However, you should have one more concern. And that concern is getting ready.
And I've been ready.
In here. I've never seen anyone use the bear hug, but it's damn sure appropriate here after what's happened to The Rock's lower back at the hands of the challenger.
There's nothing he can't do. If he smells a weakness, if he smells even the smallest weakness, Kurt Angle will pick you apart. He will dissect his opponent, and he will become a WWF champion again.
Kurt Angle showing us exactly the skills that made him the WWF champion. That showed exactly why he won the 1996 gold medal in the Olympics. He is physically, is Kurt Angle dissecting the WWF champion. There's no way The Rock can withstand this much longer. His hand dropping once. And again, one more time, this match is over, and we've got a new WWF champion. Referee, and The Rock, putting his hands up. The Rock did not grab his hands. The Rock's gonna reach down to places he may have never been before. Oh, the Rock got him, but The Rock's hurt.
He can't follow up, and if he can't follow up, and if he can't score the pin, that gives Angle enough time to recover from the Rock Bottom.
Just like Angle couldn't follow up on the Angle Slam. The Rock's got the Rock Bottom. Can he crawl on top? Can The Rock hook the leg? He grabs a knee pad. There's a cover. And my God, that was close. Angle got his shoulders up.
Watch this. Wham! Rock Bottom. The Rock takes down Angle, but he could not follow up. And now Kurt Angle has to dig down deep. Now Kurt Angle has to take
Rock's missed opportunity and once again go to the top and be the WWF champion.
It's anybody's ball game with the WWF title on the line. And The Rock ducks a right hand. The score is the right of his own. The Rock trying to lay the smack down here on the challenger. And another right hand that found his mark. Right on the jaw, Kurt Angle. And up and over he goes. And here comes The Rock. The Rock now sensing an angle. Maybe a... Uh-oh. I got the referee's... I got Earl Hebner's knee, I think, or his shin or his ankle. Can't quite tell, but...
But The Rock can't be distracted. He has to take the fight to him.
Here's what happened to the referee. Kind of, Angle kind of rolled up on the referee's knee there. And there's the Spinebuster. The Rock got the Spinebuster. And here comes the most electrifying move in sports entertainment. The People's Elbow. And he scores now. The Rock scores. There's the cover. It's up. The referee's got to get there. The referee's hurt. He's trying to get there. And it's 3-0. Angle. He had a second or two thanks to the referee's injury.
Second time. That time has been on Kurt Angle's side. He got it.
Angle's got the ankle off. Look at the Rock's ankle. Angle's going to break the Rock's ankle. Challenger is going to break the champion's ankle right here in front of our very eyes.
Can you smell it? Can you smell the title changing hands?
The Rock's going to get the loss, and he does. And just let go. You got to let go.
The Rock is tapping.
But he's in the ropes.
The Rock is tapping.
But he's in the ropes.
Damn, he's tapping. It's over.
Referee's got it. Angle, they're going to break the hole. Angle's. He wants to break the Rock's ankle.
The Rock is tapping.
Oh, wait a minute, damn it. What the hell are you doing, Kurt? Oh, no. No. Oh, my God. Wait a minute. There's a lot of mistake. Austin, attack. Attacking Angle. Angle is going to break Denver's ankle, for God's sakes. And that was a stop with a mud hole in Angle. And by God, walking it dry.
You never, ever, ever put your hands on another man's wife. Austin warned him.
Oh, wait. The stunner. What the hell? Austin assaulted an angle. He just stunned The Rock.
He warned him. He told him. Austin told Angle, don't go near my wife. And he warned The Rock. And if anything happened to Debra, it would be The Rock's end.
Yeah, but the Autumn. The Rock does not stop by Austin and Debra, The Rock's manager. Trying to handle The Rock, my God. Austin gave the warning. But I never thought it would come to this. Just 20 days from WrestleMania. Oh, my God. What else? Oh.
Like to announce the first official act of the Regal regime. There will be a World Wrestling Federation title rematch against The Rock and the very deserving Kurt Angle.
Tonight, I take back what belongs to me, my WWF title.
And as an added bonus, I'll snap The Rock's ankle too.
What about The Rock's manager, Deborah?
If she gets in my way, I just might have to take matters into my own hands.
Do you have a problem with my wife? I am the last son of a that you want to thump. Do you understand me?
I don't have a problem with Deborah.
Hey, just so we understand each other, I just had a little talk with Kurt. And if something happens to Deborah, I'm gonna whip his. And just so you know, I'll whip your too.
The World Wrestling Federation Championship on the line. What an opportunity for Kurt Angle to become the WWF Champion before WrestleMania.
He wants this more than anything else in his life.
Three belly-to-belly overhead suplexes, the steel chairs, the security walls. How much more can the WWF Champion withstand here? The Rock's got to reach down to places he may have never been before. Spinebuster! The Rock got the Spinebuster! And here comes the most electrifying
Entertainment, the People's Elbow, and he scores with it. The Rock scores. There's the cover. It's up. The referee's got to get there. The referee's hurt. Referee's trying to get there. And it's 3-0. Angle, he had a second or two thanks to the referee's injury.
Wait.
He got it. The ankle lock.
He got it.
Angle's got the ankle lock on Rock. Angle's going to break the Rock's ankle.
Can you spell the title changing hand?
Oh, wait a minute, damn it! What the hell are you doing, Kurt? Oh, no! No! Oh, my God! Wait a minute, there's a rattlesnake! Austin, attack again! Angle is going to break Deborah's ankle, for God's sakes!
Austin warned him!
Wait! No, the stunner! Stunner! What the hell? Austin assaulted Angle! He just stunned a Rock! Austin gave the warning! But I never thought it would come to this!
Steve, we are less than 3 weeks away from perhaps the biggest WrestleMania in the history of the World Wrestling Federation. The main event, Stone Cold Steve Austin challenging The Rock for the World Wrestling Federation Championship. Looking at this strictly as a professional, what does this particular WrestleMania mean to Stone Cold?
Well, it means I did what I had to do to get there. I won the Royal Rumble, which gave me the shot at the champ at WrestleMania. It turns out that the champ is The Rock. So seeing as The Rock is the best, he is the champ, either I go in there and beat him and become the champ, or I get my ass whipped. It's real simple.
Personally, what does this WrestleMania mean to Steve Austin? Personally.
Well, personally, it's in Texas. Hell, it's my backyard. It's in the Astrodome. I've seen baseball games, football games, and now Stone Cold Steve Austin and The Rock are in the main event. But the biggest deal to me is it means I'm back. The journey's over. I'm back.
Certainly referring to your spinal surgery last January, your doctors, your family, your friends, perhaps the only person in the world that thought you were going to come back was you. And, you know, a lot of the critics, your critics, say, well, yeah, Stone Cold, he's obsessed, JR. Stone Cold is obsessed in becoming the WWF champion again. How do you address those people?
You know, I've always said, if you ain't here to be the World Wrestling Federation champion, you got no business being here. Pretty much that's your answer.
All right. Take
it how you want it.
Okay, I'm with you on that. And you win the Royal Rumble. The next month, The Rock goes to No Way Out and wins the WWF title, and the hype begins. Austin and Rock, Rock and Austin, WrestleMania, it's in one sentence. And then it looked like clear sailing was ended when Mr. McMahon reared his head and named your wife your opponent's manager. Your wife, Deborah, is now managing The Rock. Why would Mr. McMahon do something like that?
Because he's a sorry, sorry son of a b-. It's because Austin versus McMahon lasted well over a year. You'd think it was over. I beat his so many times, I can't even count it on my own fingers. So you'd think he'd had enough of Stone Cold, but now he gets a chance to shove it right back at Stone Cold Steve Austin. So that's what he does. He can't deal with me one-on-one. He can't handle Stone Cold one-on-one, so he makes my wife The Rock's manager. Am I happy about it? No. But McMahon is a sorry son of a and he's still trying to screw with Stone Cold Steve Austin.
Obviously an emotional subject, and rightfully so.
You're damn right.
But Steve, a lot of The Rock's fans don't understand why you stunned the WWF champion Monday night on Raw. They don't get it.
You don't get why I stunned The Rock. I told that man right to his face, walked to his dressing room, walked up to him and said, hey, if you put Deborah in jeopardy, I'm gonna whip your ass. He proceeded to go out there, put Deborah in jeopardy, so he got his ass whipped. What part of that, or what part of any fan does not understand that? And I don't care who likes it, who doesn't like it. That was my wife. She was put in jeopardy. Bam! Lights out.
Another man you warned Monday night was Kurt Angle. And tonight, you're going to face Kurt Angle one-on-one on SmackDown. And I got a feeling in the mood you're in, after what happened to your own wife Monday night, this ain't gonna be no wrestling match.
Boy, you're pretty smart, but it ain't gonna be no damn wrestling match. There's gonna be a ring up there with a couple of ropes around it, and that's the only part of wrestling that's gonna look like. Kurt Angle has his weapon coming, and that's what he's gonna get. You don't mess with Stone Cold Steve Austin. You do not mess with my wife. That's what he did. He will pay the price tonight. And you know what? Tonight, there's going to be a winner and there's going to be a loser. And sandwiched in between, there's going to be a lot of brutality. And Kurt Angle's going to be on the receiving end of that. So I beat his beat him 1, 2, 3 to put a little period at the end of the sentence. All said and done, Kurt Angle doesn't need to screw with Stone Cold Steve Austin.
And let's not forget that the WWF champion, The Rock, is scheduled to be in Anaheim tonight as well.
I'm glad that The Rock is in Anaheim just as well. It makes my heart jump out of my chest. And I got a message for The Rock. You know, there's no love lost there. We're not buddies. I don't necessarily hate the man. I respect what he's done. But that being said, him being the champ, him and me going to WrestleMania for the WWF title, I suggest he park his little carcass in front of a monitor and watch Stone Cold Steve Austin open up a can of whoop and spread it all over Kurt Angle's. Because when I roll into Houston, Texas at WrestleMania, don't think I'm coming to do a little song and dance routine. These boots were made for stomping, and I'll stomp his little guts in to get the World Wrestling Federation title. But we ain't even got to worry about that right now. Let me just settle the hell down. Kurt Angle is the victim tonight. And the chips will fall where they will. And it doesn't look too good for Kurt Angle. And that's pretty much all I got to say about any kind of question you can ask me.
Oh, look at his eyes!
Stone Cold Steve Austin with a look of... Oh, man.
It's no DQ.
And Angle wisely getting the steel chair off his ankle. Hey, look at it. Angle's got the ring bell in his hand. Angle with the ring bell. Oh. Shot to Austin. A wise move by Angle.
Angle needs to get in the ring, go for a cover right now.
He's had the hell beat out. Wait a minute.
Oh,
The Rock. The bomb of ball. The Rock making his way down to the ring. Staring at Angle. It's no disqualification.
He's staring at Austin, too.
The Rock is throwing Angle back into the ring. The Rock throwing Angle into the ring as if he wants Angle to pin Austin here.
What the hell's going on?
And Angle struggling, trying to get to the rattlesnake. This crowd's in shock.
He's got him.
He's got him. Angle's got Austin. No! Austin kicks out. But I can't believe The Rock threw Angle in to pin Austin. The Rock went through a battle. Angle tried to break The Rock's ankle.
Oh, he's coming over here.
Rock, what the hell are you doing? Why the hell did you try to screw Austin? Why did you throw Angle
in? Shut your mouth, Michael Cole. The fact of the matter is that The Rock just came down and wanted the match to continue.
Wanted the match to continue? Wait a minute. Angle with a suplex to Austin. No disqualification in this matchup. Well, Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin said he was going to send a message to you in this matchup.
Message The Rock's ass. Stone Cold Steve Austin gave The Rock a threat. And there ain't nobody, and The Rock means nobody, that threatens The Rock, whether it be Stone Cold Steve Austin, Vince McMahon, or George W. Bush himself.
Well, Rock, Stone Cold Steve Austin did warn you Monday night. The safety of my wife, Deborah, is in your hands. Make sure that she's not in jeopardy. Stone Cold warned you.
Stone Cold didn't warn The Rock of nothing. Stone Cold threatened The Rock. Since when all of a sudden is Deborah The Rock's wife? When does she become The Rock's responsibility?
What a suplex by Angle. But don't you feel any responsibility for your manager, Austin's wife, Deborah? Any responsibility at all?
The Rock said it before and he'll say it again. The Rock has no problem with Deborah. The Rock does have a problem, however, with Stone Cold telling The Rock of his responsibilities. There's no ring on The Rock's hand. There's not a 10-carat diamond on Deborah's hand. She's not The Rock's wife. She's Stone Cold's wife.
Austin,
all of a sudden, Austin gets off at The Rock because Angle put her in ankle lock submission hold.
Oh, look at Austin trying to battle back against Angle. Who do you feel responsible? responsible. You feel Mr. McMahon's responsible for putting everybody in this situation by naming Deborah your manager?
No question. Vince McMahon is a manipulating son of a...
Luthes press! Luthes press! Austin, hammered away! The right hand angle! Austin trying to send a message to the front of the ball! And what a right hand! No disqualification in this matchup.
Want it right out here.
Look out, Angle tossed out in front of us. And Stone Cold, 17 days away from a collision with the Rock.
17 days away from the collision of a lifetime. Right up.
Oh, Angle, right off the table as Austin just stares at the Rock, the Brahma Bull, his opponent.
This is for the Rock, the Rock's ass. How about that? How'd that feel like?
Wait a minute.
Who's he gonna take out? He's better take out Austin so he get a shot at it at the Rock.
No disqualification. Look at Angle's face. He's incensed. He's outraged. Angle's gonna take somebody. Cut off. Angle hit the Rock. The Rock is out. And out with Austin. Angle is a one-man wrecking crew.
Angle took out Rock and Austin. Man, I'm looking right at the Rock's eyes. He's out.
Oh, man, we gotta take another look, Taz. First, listen to this shot. A chair to the Rock. And then Angle, outraged. A chair to Austin.
They better get somebody out and help Rock. He ain't looking too good. Damn.
Angle threw Austin back into the ring. No disqualification. Kurt Angle trying to gain momentum, trying to take advantage. Olympic champion, the former WWF champion, in control.
Moonsault
got him. The moonsault got him. Here's the cover.
This is it.
Hook of the leg.
It's over.
He's got him. Two. Austin gets the shoulder up.
How the hell did he kick out of that?
Oh my God. Austin.
The Rock. The Rock's up. Like he says, can't stop the Rock. Just what the Rock said.
And look at Kurt Angle. He can't believe that the Brahma Bull, the Rock is up. Is furious. Look at the look in the Rock's eyes. Austin to his feet. Went for the stunner. Austin shoved into the Rock by Angle again. Great drop toehold.
Angle lock.
Angle trying to break Austin's ankle. If he breaks Austin's ankle, Angle's going to WrestleMania. If Angle breaks the Austin's ankle, he's going to WrestleMania. And the Rock breaks it up. And here comes the Brahma Bull.
He's on fire!
The Rock is stalking Austin! He's stalking Austin!
He set him up! He wants that Rock bottom pole!
Retaliation for the stunner on Monday! Here it comes!
He's holding
the Rock bottom Angle from behind! Kurt Angle from behind! And look at Angle! No disqualification! This match is still going on! All hell is broken loose!
It's chaos! It's a war! Here it comes!
Rock bottom! Rock bottom!
Angle trying to break Austin's ankle. If
what we understand, and The Rock is still...
Hey, Rock, I know you've been waiting out here all night, and I'm assuming you're waiting for Stone Cold Steve Austin, so I gotta tell you, we just got word his flight has been delayed.
Stone Cold Steve Austin's flight's been delayed. Now Stone Cold has flight problems. Well, how convenient. Well, The Rock says this, Coach. You go down to the Albany International Airport and you wait for Stone Cold Steve Austin. As soon as Stone Cold takes one step off the plane, you tell him that The Rock is at the arena waiting.
Steve Austin, The Rock wanted to come out here and say this to your face, but seeing as you don't have the courtesy to be here, The Rock is gonna say it anyway. Stone Cold Steve Austin, after last Monday night, stunner to The Rock. After last Thursday night, stunner to The Rock. And after all that, the night, tonight, that you were supposed to come face to face with The Rock, all of a sudden, you've got plane troubles.
That could happen to anybody.
Well, quite frankly speaking, Stone Cold Steve Austin, you got something much bigger than plane troubles. You've got rock troubles. So Stone Cold The Rock says this. He's out here to say one thing. One thing only, simply put, The Rock isn't waiting until WrestleMania.
13 days away.
And Stone Cold The Rock says this. You enjoy the rest of your flight. You sit back, relax, have yourself a drink, watch a movie, have some peanuts, have a blast. Because The Rock says, the second you step foot in this arena, your bald-headed, double-studded candy ass belongs to The Rock.
Did The Rock just call Austin a candy ass?
Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Wow.
If you smell what The Rock is cooking.
Well, there's certainly provocation for The Rock, and they're getting two stunners. One last Monday, one last Thursday on SmackDown as well. But The Rock tonight, to meet both Benoit and Kurt Angle. What's up with that? As we get nearer and nearer to the showdown of the ages at WrestleMania.
Yeah.
Stone Cold Steve Austin's plane has arrived. He's due here at any moment. And when he does get here, we'll attempt. Wait a second. Stone Cold, Deborah. Steve. The Rock has sent me out here. He's been waiting for you at the arena all night long. And Steve, The Rock has called you out.
The Rock's calling me out.
Yeah, he wants you at the arena.
You hear that? I got my braces right here, honey. Let's get in the car. You just got that man's ass whooped. And while I'm at it, why don't you stay here and get my bags for me?
With a spinning heel kick from Jericho, desperately needs to make the tag here. The Rock is ready. He is rested. The Rock wants the tag.
Someone needs to make a tag, and the first tag clearly gets the advantage.
And The Rock got the tag, and so did Benoit. And The Rock is on fire, the WWE champion. Reversing again. Oh, what a great little throw. Upper body throw. And Kurt Angle in, Kurt Angle out. The commissioner down. The Rock is dominating. Champion. There's a cover. Should be all there. Oh, wait a minute. Kurt Angle pulling the rope right out of the ring. I think The Rock had been blocked. And wait a minute. Jericho's got Regal. And the walls of Jericho and Benoit back up. Oh,
by Jericho. That's pinball reverses. The Rock and Angle on the outside. There's a Lion's Heart driving the air out of pinball. The shot down goes the commissioner. And out comes Jericho. The Rock and Angle right here. The Rock's head bouncing off this table. Regal and Jericho on the outside. But the focus of the ring of Kurt Angle and The Rock. And The Rock trying to counter and does into the spine buster.
He's going for it.
No, he's not. He thought about going for it. Oh, wait. The
cross face. Cross face.
Benoit will rip and tear that shoulder apart.
And the ankle lock is
my God. My God, The Rock's going to be stabbed. Crackle on top. The face across Jericho. That's not going to happen yet. Or has it already happened?
Jericho just saved. Just saved The Rock's life right there.
And Regal with a title belt. Knocking down Jericho. Regal. Come on, 3-on-2. The Rock has things going. And a cheap shot by the commissioner with that damn belt.
The Rock's taking a bad beating. He was in the crippling crossface and in the ankle lock at the same time. They were going to rip him into four pieces.
The WWF champion being assaulted him by 3 mid-weights. Stone Cold. Austin here from the airport.
WrestleMania, April 1st, without a doubt, this is the most eagerly anticipated main event in WrestleMania history. This certainly could be the biggest WrestleMania in World Wrestling Federation history as well. What does Rock, the WWF Championship, as a professional, what does it mean to you being the WWF Champion? What does that title mean to you?
Well, being the WWF Champion solidifies the fact that you are at the mountaintop, solidifies the fact that you've grabbed that brass ring. It's something I've worked very hard for my entire life because I grew up in the industry. That's the reason why I'm here in the WWF. So being the WWF champion solidifies the fact that I'm the absolute best.
Steve, on SmackDown last week, you spoke of this hellacious journey personally for you back. Have you changed your thoughts about what this match means in the last 7 days since we talked about it?
Well, I didn't change a damn thing about what I thought. It means Stone Cold Steve Austin is back. I can stop talking about it. The journey's over. It's Stone Cold Steve Austin versus The Rock for the World Wrestling Federation title. That's what it is.
It certainly seems to me, and certainly not degrading the WWF title, because that's it. Anybody that passes through the doors of the WWF, as you have said, Steve, should be here for one thing and one thing only, that's to become the WWF champion. But it seems to me that thanks to Mr. McMahon assigning Stone Cold's wife, Deborah, as The Rock's manager, that has heightened, to me, the personal animosity, the personal issue between the two of you.
Well, it's heightened a lot of things. It's heightened the animosity, professional as well as personal. The fact of the matter is this, is I never asked for Deborah to be my manager, never wanted Deborah to be my manager, and I'll go on the record as saying I have no problem with Deborah personally, or professionally for that matter. But the fact of the matter is this, is she's not my responsibility. She's not my wife. She's your wife.
Let me go on record as saying that I don't like the fact that my wife is your manager, because there's a conflict of interest there. If she's supposed to be your manager and I'm wrestling you for the World Wrestling Federation Championship at WrestleMania, yeah, that's a problem. That's a big problem. But I expect that my wife should have a career and all more power to her. I'm getting a little worked up here and I just try to settle down. And I'll tell you right now, I don't like the tone of your voice when you mention my name or my wife.
Well,
you might want to take a little bass out of your voice.
Well, I might not.
Let me go ahead and cut you off here. Let's just go ahead and take Deborah out of the equation. Bam, she's a non-factor. The fact is, Rock, you got the WWF title, and I want it. Can we change the scenario? No. Just don't even worry about that. Just don't even go there. You got what I want. Enough said about that.
What do you, people are wondering, this animosity? Do you hate each other? Personally, what do you think of this man? He is the champion, personally, as a human being.
Personally, what I think about The Rock?
Right.
He's probably a wonderful human being and a credit to the human race and a lot of people's views. In my opinion, I care less about The Rock, personally.
Your thoughts on Stone Cold as a human being, Rock? I know you're...
You know, it's no mystery. There's no mystery how I feel about Stone Cold. There's no mystery how Stone Cold feels about The Rock. We've gone from good to bad, bad to good. We've done it all across the whole spectrum. But the fact of the matter is this, professionally, I've earned his respect. Professionally, he's earned mine. When we get in that ring together, he brings out the best in The Rock. The Rock brings out the best in Stone Cold, no question. Personally, I don't like him.
I don't think we need to let this degenerate.
I'm trying to be a pro over here, right?
I hope
that ain't gonna last much longer. Keep sassing me.
Well, let's focus back on WrestleMania.
How come you never asked what the belt meant to me?
All right, good question.
You said, what's it like to be back at WrestleMania? Ask me what the belt meant to me.
I'll paraphrase
everything he said. It means I'm the number one in the industry. Bottom line. That's my opinion what the belt means to me. I just thought you should ask me the question, too.
Oh, okay.
A little one-sided here, if you ask me.
All right, well, I'll ask you another question, if you don't mind. And that question is, as the challenger, the onus is going to be on you in the Astrodome at WrestleMania, because we're looking at one fall, 16-minute time limit. He's the WWF champion. He doesn't have to beat you, but you damn sure got to beat him. Strategically, does that change game plans, mindset, or is it still full speed ahead?
It's full speed ahead, because when I get in there with The Rock in the Astrodome, 65,000 screaming fans watching every single move that happens in that ring, yeah, I got to beat that man. I've never wrestled an hour in my life, but if that's what it takes to get the job done, that's exactly what I'll do. My strategy is to go in there, do whatever it takes to beat The Rock, 1, 2, 3, to become the World Wrestling Federation champion.
Rock, without revealing your hand and your strategy, your mindset as far as your approach to this as competitor to competitor.
Revealing my hand and my strategy. Now, the fact of the matter is this, is you brought up a very good point, Jim Ross, is that The Rock doesn't have to beat Stone Cold, but Stone Cold has to beat The Rock. But as far as I'm concerned, the belt is dangling, and we're both going for it. So I got one reason, and one reason only, to go inside that ring, and that is to beat Stone Cold Steve Austin. It's just that simple. Well, I'm just going to go in there and back off just because I'm the champion.
Yeah, I'm glad you said that, because I don't want you to be on defense the whole match. Yeah, I appreciate the fact that you want to beat Stone Cold as much as I need to beat you, because I don't want you on defense all night long. I appreciate the fact that you want to whip my It ain't going to happen, but I appreciate your mentality.
Oh, well, I'm glad you appreciate my mentality. I'm glad you appreciate the fact that I want to whip your so much. But see how much you'll appreciate it on April 1st. See how much you'll appreciate it then.
You know what? You got that little T-shirt that says, just bring it on the front of it. Well, that night when you're looking up at the lights and that little T-shirt says, just bring it, you will know that Stone Cold just brought of it.
Yeah. Well, you got your little T-shirt right there too, Austin 316. Austin 316 says, I just whipped your right? Well, I say, just bring it. You say, I just whipped your So on April 1st, why don't you just come try and whip the Rock?
Obviously, the the emotion, and I understand the emotion because of what's at stake. What's at stake is the WWF title at WrestleMania. But in closing this interview, and again, I appreciate your professionalism. I know it's not easy. Any closing remarks, Rock, as the champion to the challenger?
Yeah, we could talk about one fall, two falls, 60 minutes, 60 days. Talk about Deborah being my manager, whose responsibility it is. It's his wife. It's this is happening. It doesn't matter. The only thing that matters is April 1st, WrestleMania 17, the biggest of all time. The Rock and Austin, the biggest of all time. The fact of the matter is this, is I will give you every drop of sweat, every drop of blood, every ounce of energy I have. Win, lose, or draw, you are going to get the absolute best of The Rock at WrestleMania. And there's a reason why they call me The Rock. There's a reason why they call me the most electrifying man the world has ever seen and all that. And there's a reason why they call me the best. Come April 1, two unstoppable forces will meet. And all questions will be answered.
Steve, your final thoughts about this match?
Yeah. Without getting overly sentimental, I'll go on the record as saying every single time that I've been in the ring with The Rock, he has brought out the absolute best in Stone Cold Steve Austin. So when I roll in to the Astrodome in WrestleMania on April 1st, do I want to beat you on a personal level? Oh, hell yeah, I do. But on a professional level, which bleeds over in my personal existence, I need to beat you, Rock. I need it more than anything that you can ever imagine. So that's the mentality I roll into the Astrodome with, the fact that Stone Cold Steve Austin is back and that I must beat The Rock to be the World Wrestling Federation champion once again. And there is no other way. There can be only one. There can be only one World Wrestling Federation champion. And that will be Rock when it's all said and done. Stone Cold Steve Austin, with all due respect.
Gentlemen, thank you very much for your time, and best of luck to both of you at WrestleMania.
Stone Cold, could I ask you a quick question about your match tonight? You have to team with The Rock against Undertaker and Kane.
Excuse me. We're walking all around looking for Steve Austin's locker room. Do you know where it's at?
It's down that way.
Down that way. Down that way, left, right, up, down, where?
Down and to the right.
Down to the right. Are you new? The Rock.
My name's...
No. Thank you. Excuse The Rock, one second. Just so we're clear on this, you don't want to team with The Rock, The Rock doesn't want to team with you. Our match against The Undertaker and Kane tonight, just as long as we know, you don't mess with The Rock won't mess with you.
But now, hold on. What you're saying is cool with me, but when the match is over, all bets are off. Is that understood?
You're damn right it is. Good.
Well, Austin will take the tag, but he doesn't look extremely involved. There's a tag right there. Maybe I was wrong. And Austin the Undertaker. These two big men hammering each other with their right hands, and the Undertaker gets the better of the situation. And Austin comes back, and Austin nearly came. But Undertaker taking Austin down, almost out of the rattlesnake's boots. Stone Cold and The Rock, all the hype. It's almost over. Now, wait a minute. There's a Rock. Rock trying to pull Kane off the apron. As Austin got the Irish hooked to the corner by the Undertaker. And now Kane and The Rock are fighting on the outside. Austin taking that foot right to the face of the Undertaker. Luke Bass press. Piston-like right hands by the Rattlesnake. And Kane hammered Austin right in the back of the head. Again, The Rock and Kane on the outside, hammering each other.
Yeah, but more importantly, on the inside, Austin is down
and The Undertaker is standing over him. And The Undertaker knows how to take advantage of a situation.
The Undertaker picking Austin up and measuring him. And now the Rattlesnake helplessly upon the Undertaker's shoulder. But Austin able to kick three, looking for the Stunner. And The Undertaker shooting Austin right into the Rock.
He got him by the throat.
Here, look, there could be a choke slam. Yes, it is a choke slam. The Undertaker just choke slammed the hell out of Austin. And Kane dropping the Rock right on our table. Face first.
Oh, wait. The Undertaker's going for the last guy.
Wait a minute.
He's going for the last guy.
There's the Triple H. And a tear right to the back of The Undertaker's head. I thought Triple H was on vacation. And now Kane and the Gang on the outside. Austin's got the cover. Austin's got the cover. Stone Cold beats The Undertaker. Thanks to the Gang. Sunday at WrestleMania, there's going to be some serious hell to pay.
And now I think it's time for Triple H to take a vacation until either SmackDown or WrestleMania. He stopped off in Cleveland for just a moment to say hello.
That's true. Can Triple H imagine what he has done to the American Badass just 6 days before WrestleMania? Oh my God, there's going to be hell to pay. And Stone Cold,
the lucky man, because if The Undertaker would have hit that last ride, in my personal opinion, he would have beat Stone Cold Steve Austin.
I don't think there's any doubt about that, but that's not the way that it went down. And Stone Cold celebrating a victory here tonight, but is he celebrating in advance what he hopes to do this Sunday at WrestleMania on pay-per-view? And I tell you, that was... Wait a minute. There's The Rock back in the ring. I don't think he'll be celebrating with Austin, but maybe I'm wrong.
Oh, you're wrong. In my opinion, you're dead wrong.
Oh, there's The Rock. Wait a minute. The Rock just gave the Stone Cold Stunner. The Stone Cold Steve Austin. You talk about stopping it. In the Rattlesnake's face, the WWF champion has just given Stone Cold's own finishing maneuver. And Deborah, Austin's wife, The Rock's manager, can't believe what she is seeing. And now The Rock calling for the cold beverage.
How personal can this get?
And now, The Rock just gave Austin a beer to remember him by. The Rock just stunned Stone Cold Steve Austin. And by God, can you imagine what it's going to be like when Austin comes to? Can you imagine what it's going to be like this Sunday at WrestleMania? The biggest extravaganza in the history of the WWF. And that man, The Rock, has just shoved it. The gut of Stone Cold Steve Austin. And now the tip, the salute, the toast. My God, WrestleMania, The Rock and Austin, Sunday.
Hey, it's The Rock, the WWE champion.
Now, what you did on Monday night stunning Stone Cold Steve Austin may have pleased you, but it wasn't well received. And so, Steve Austin will be here soon. And Mr. McMahon has informed me to make sure that nothing happens to his main event at WrestleMania. So what I suggest you do is go along to your dressing room and remain there and keep out of trouble, if that's okay.
Aren't you the guy that drank pee last week?
Mr. McMahon has told me to inform you...
Yeah. So The Rock understands now. So not only do you drink pee, but you're some sort of messenger boy.
You listen to me. I am the World Wrestling Federation.
And I am The Rock, the WWF champion, the one who stunned Stone Cold Steve Austin last Monday night on Raw.
So you want The Rock to stay out of trouble tonight on The Rock Show SmackDown?
Yes, sir.
You want no trouble from The Rock? You want The Rock to go over there and sit in his dressing room?
Yes.
No problem.
It's Stone Cold! Austin's here!
Bloody time. Who the hell do you think you are? Mr. McMahon has informed me to inform you that he doesn't want anything happening to his main event at WrestleMania. So I hope you... I hope you're bloody listening.
This is real simple. I didn't come out here to just flap my gums. I got something to say to a man face to face. So Rock, bring your little carcass to the ring right now.
Uh-oh. That's not what Mr. McMahon wants.
And just so I make myself clear, I ain't asking, I'm telling you to bring your carcass to this ring.
Commissioner Regal warning Austin not to start anything tonight. Mr. McMahon concerned that his main event at WrestleMania could be in jeopardy. Wait a minute. Eve of WrestleMania.
I said I wanted to Rock, not a jackass.
Now listen, I've had a bad couple of days as of late, and I'm not gonna let, shut up, and I'm not gonna let you.
You cannot reason with a rattlesnake. Why is Mr. McMahon out here?
I'm not gonna let you ruin my WrestleMania. Oh no. I told the commissioner, and I'm telling you, this WrestleMania main event is going to be intact, and it's going to make it this Sunday. And I don't know what you've got in your mind, Stone Cold Steve Austin, but it's not good. So I would advise you to get the hell out of the ring. That's right now.
Uh-oh.
Wait a minute! Austin with the right hand! Dropping the
I'm glad you come out here, Rock, because I got something to get off my chest. Last Monday night, you did something to Stone Cold Steve Austin ain't never been done before. You gave Stone Cold Steve Austin a Stone Cold Stunner. And not only that, when you finished giving me the stunner, you proceeded to drink Stone Cold Steve Austin's beer. And I know you're in my space right now. You might want to back up. You might not believe me when I say this, Rock, and I don't give a rat if you do or not anyway, but I respect what you did. Because like I said, ain't nobody ever did that to Stone Cold Steve Austin before. Give me a damn beer. Give me one more beer. Since you like drinking beer so much all of a sudden, I thought I might make a little toast to The Rock. Here's to your health. Here's to your happiness. And here's to you, Rock, walking down that aisle at WrestleMania as the WWF champion for the very last time.
Oh! That's either a toast or a challenge. It's one or the other!
Oh,
was a fine toast, but The Rock has a toast of his own. Here's to your health. Here's to your happiness. And here's to your ass getting whooped at WrestleMania.
As of now, you are managing The Rock.
Austin's wife's managing The Rock? What the hell is that?
I never asked for Deborah to be my manager, never wanted Deborah to be my manager. But the fact of the matter is this, is she's not my responsibility. She's not my wife. She's your wife.
Angle is going to break Deborah's ankle, for God's sakes. Wait a minute, there's a rattlesnake. You never, ever, ever put your hands on another man's wife. Austin warned him. Hey, wait.
Let's just go ahead and take Deborah out of the equation. Bam, she's non-factor. The fact is, Rock, you got the WWF title, and I want it.
The Brahma Bull is furious. He's stalking Austin. Set him up. He wants that rock bottom. Here it comes. He's going to rock bottom angle from behind. All hell is broken loose. Here it comes. Rock bottom. Rock bottom to angle. Look at Austin. Look at Austin. Stop. How will the Rock retaliate? There could be hell to pay for Austin.
That's Stone Cold Steve Austin. The Rock isn't waiting until WrestleMania. Your bald-headed, double-studded candy ass belongs to The Rock.
Wait a minute! The Rock just gave the Stone Cold Stunner! The Stone Cold Steve Austin!
How personal can this get?
Can you imagine what it's gonna be like at WrestleMania?
Just one more fight and I'll be...
it, and you'll be the one who's left missing me.
Austin316 says, I just whipped your ass. Right? Well, I say just bring it. You say, I just whipped your ass. So on April 1st, why don't you just come try and whip the Rock's ass?
This whole setup has been nothing but a bunch of from the start. Vince McMahon makes my wife the Rock's manager. The Rock gives Stone Cold Steve Austin a stutter. The Rock drinks Stone Cold Steve Austin's beer. That's more. Bottom line is, Kelly, and look at me, you and I told everybody, the bottom line is, Stone Cold Steve Austin needs to be the World Wrestling Federation champion.